So, I've always been a big fan of knock tuning, but it's actually kind of an imperfect science because if you're not shooting absolutely perfect every single time, your corrections might be false. So if you're using a shooting machine and you're knock tuning and that, because that thing's shooting the same way every single time, that's more accurate. So what I like to do is first bend indexing, and my friends over at Arizona Archery Club taught me how to do this, and ever since I've been doing it, it's been like lights out difference. So a lot of you guys have asked me what first bend indexing is. So what I do is I cut the shaft to length, and then we put in a glue-in style, just a glue-in style point on either end, right? Okay. And I have a little indention on either side of my bow press. They're exactly the same distance, and I measured it with a caliper, same distance apart, same distance on each side, basically. So you have the most parallel hole you can have, or most equal hole you can have. Anyway, so you put it in the bow press, and then this arrow is going to want to have, especially arrows that are 0.3, 0.003 or more straightness. So it's a little harder on the 0.001s, but like anything that's 0.003 or worse, when you put it in, it's going to want to have a natural bend. Okay, and you can see there is a bend right here. That is, and this I happen to put in. Okay, it's bending down. It's bending down and that way. So what I want to do is whichever way the bend is, this is the weakest. Right here is the weakest right now. I'm gonna put a mark on the opposite side of that. So I'm gonna show you from a little different angle here. I always try to put the same side the same way when I'm doing a batch of arrows. It doesn't matter which side, but once I start a batch, I start that way. So meaning like this side is going to be my knock side, and this is my excuse me, my point side. And one of the things I'm doing, and I found that this is going to give me the best, you don't need to bend it very much. Just start. I don't know if you could see the way that bend. This has kind of got a slope down. Every time it bends, I back it out and I spin the arrow so that I want the bend to come upwards. And the reason why I want it to come upwards is so that I can get here and look and see exactly where it is, and I can make the most precise mark. Because if you try to mark it when they're bending in different directions, then a lot of times it'll be inaccurate. And the other thing is too, by doing that, you can verify for sure that that's the weakest point. Because if it starts to bend a different way, then either you got a bad arrow, or now, like I was saying with the 0.001s, when you have a super straight, super consistent spine, this little trick's hard, very hard to do. So again, this one's bending down right from the get-go, almost completely straight down. I'm gonna give it a 180 turn. It should come up. Yep, there it goes. See, now it's bending up. And then I just come here and verify. Yep, I'm getting pretty good about not having to turn it very many times, but sometimes it takes a few adjustments. So what this is gonna do for me is the arrow is gonna leave my bow. It's gonna bend the same way each time, because every arrow I have basically indexed the bend. So it should leave my bow the same way. Now this is one that I fletched up already, and you can see, so I have the cock vein aligned with the mark that I made. So the stiffest spot is on top, and that's going to make the arrow bend into my rest when it leaves. And you could have it, and it really doesn't matter which way. You could have it bend it out to the left, bend it out to the right. It doesn't have, I like it this way. I feel like it does the best for me. But the point is that the arrow is going to leave your bow the same way every single time.